All right, guys, what is going on? Lux here from The MD Journey, helping you succeed on your medical journey with less stress. This video, I'm going to answer a question from one of my subscribers who asked me, how do you deal with self-doubt or fear of failure or just failure in general on your medical journey? And it's an amazing question. We all deal with it. So I'm going to give you not only my personal example of something that I consider to be a failure at the moment, but also give you the top five things that I always do when I'm in a position of doubting myself. So we're going to get to those tips after this intro. All right, guys, let's get to the video. First of all, if you are new, welcome to the channel. My name is Lakshay. I'm a fourth year medical student who has been teaching and helping both pre-meds and medical students over the last 2.5 years on how to do well with a little bit less stress. So if you enjoy that concept and you enjoyed this video, first of all, make sure you give it a like, subscribe to the channel. I think we are almost at 1,000 subscribers by the making of this video, so make sure, help us get there. But let's get to the video, which is what are the five things you can do to overcome self-doubt, fear of failure, and actual failure. And let me share with you a quick example, a story of mine. Back to my pre-med days, you know, some of the most common examples we have as failures on our medical journey is when a test or an interview or an application process didn't go our way. Those are usually the things that most people consider to be a failure. And something that really resonated with me at that time was when I took my MCAT. It was a terrible test. I did decently fine, but the score that I got back was not representative of where I wanted. You know, I was trying to shoot for the stars, and the score wasn't going to allow me to do that, or at least it didn't seem like that on the surface. When I got my score, I was disappointed, a little bit just uncomfortable and uneasy, and I considered myself to, at that moment, to have self-doubts, to feel like I wasn't good enough, and maybe if I'm not doing well on the initial test that you have to take to go into medical school, maybe I wasn't good enough to become a physician. And, you know, obviously I wiped that away because I'm at this point where I'm about to become a physician in about like 5 months. So it's super exciting, but I'm going to show you guys five different things that I've learned along the way that I did back then that have helped me overcome, you know, these mental hurdles as well as these actual life events that can kind of make it feel like you're taking a couple of steps back. So let's get to those tips. So the first tip that I like to give you guys is when you're in a position of fearing a failure or actual failure, make sure you understand that you separate your failure or your self-doubt from your own identity. I like to give you a quick story. It's probably one of my favorite examples where we are looking at a young gentleman who at the age of around 24 started a business and it failed within a year. He decided after 24 that he was going to go into politics, and he failed at that in 25. He started another business the following year, also failed. Year after year, even in his 30s, continued to try to be a politician, a businessman. Every single time he would lose the race until he was 52 years old, guys. And that's when Abraham Lincoln finally got elected to become president. He had so many losses that a normal human being that didn't know how to approach failure would have probably given up. But even at the age of 52, he persevered because his failures or his setbacks, or probably the better examples, did not necessarily represent his identity. So if you have something that I like to consider to be a setback, if you have an MCAT score that may not allow you to go, you know, to the school of your dreams at that moment, it is a setback, it is not you. So you are not a failure, that situation just didn't work out. So remember that, separate yourself or separate your failures from your own identity. So tip number two that I love to give is understand this equation that lessons equals growth. People really dread that feeling of being at rock bottom. There's a great quote that I have, which is rock bottom is really just your foundation. It's going to help you become a better person if, one, you have to learn from it. So if you have a setback or if you have self-doubt, understand, you know, what were the reasons for it. For example, if you had a poor exam, it's very easy to call yourself dumb or stupid and maybe I'm not good enough, you know, I shouldn't have come through this process in the first place. But just flip it on its mindset. You know, you had a poor exam, like everyone has those. I still have those. Put that as a lesson. Ask yourself, okay, using this, how can I become a better student? How can I make sure, one, I don't get this grade again, but two, use these, you know, those lessons to become even a better student. So understand that your lessons equal your growth. So you've learned best from your mistakes. You learn best from your setbacks. So if you are feeling a sense of self-doubt, it's because you're worried too much about messing up. And sometimes, you know, messing up is going to allow you to do the best versions of yourself, you know, allow you to unleash your potential. I remember when I was making these first YouTube video, guys, a lot of you guys probably watched one of my first YouTube videos on the channel, because it's probably one of the more popular ones, but it was terrible. But versus considering that to be a failure, it is more of a lesson on how to improve. I'm still improving. These videos aren't amazing, but I'm going to learn through them and make, you know, those as my foundation to improve. So understand that lesson equals growth when you are in a situation of doubting yourself and wondering if you're good enough. So number three, and I really like to share this approach, is understand the true definition of a successful person. You know, when we're in a position of self-doubt, we are anything except successful in our own heads. And to us, you know, we think, who's successful? We point to people that are wealthy, people that have done well for themselves in terms of developing a name. If we look at our peers and we say, who's successful? We look at the people who seem to get the good grades all the time, or seem to always do well in their rotations or their classes, whatever it may be. But success is not a point in time, it is a process. And you too are successful in the eyes of somebody else. If you are a pre-med, if you are in med school, if you are about to go into residency, there are people looking at you like, man, like, I wish I could do what he or she is doing, because you have gone through so many different hurdles to be able to make it to this point. So my definition of success is basically everything that I've gone through to get to this point. I am successful today because of all the hurdles and obstacles that I have overcome. Because I know if I was to put myself back in the past and try to do it all again, it would be super difficult. And to know that I've made it to this point, I have to consider myself successful. So that helps you get through some of the self-doubt once you understand how much you really have done for yourself at this point in time. So understand that success is not a point in time, but a progress. And if you have made it to this point, whether you're a pre-med, whether you're in high school, whether you're already a med student, you are successful. You're just in a moment where you're having another setback, and you're gonna get through it just like you always have. So last two tips, and number four is me being completely honest, because I dealt with this myself, is stop doing it for other people. If you are from an immigrant family or a high expectation family, you know what I mean. Especially going into medicine, sometimes we are a little bit peer pressured into the expectations we set for ourselves, because those are really reflective of the expectations other people have for us. And then the self-doubt comes in because we are not executing or doing according to what other people want from us. You know, forget those people. They may be your parents, your loved ones, it doesn't matter. You are going to be the ones that is going to have to deal with the burden of stress. You need to set your own expectations. Stop doing it for other people. You know, my parents told me to become a physician when I was a very young kid, when I moved to this country, and I told them no countless amount of times. I chose to be a physician because of my own choice, and I continue to want to do well for myself because of my own expectations. You know, my parents want me to do well, but they don't ever continue to force upon me a goal or an expectation. And that's because I've set in stone that I really don't put priority into their expectations over mine. If I have high expectations and goals for myself, then that's all you really need. So stop doing it for other people. If you're trying to impress people, if you're, you know, trying to put on a face and you're struggling as a pre-med and the rest of your classmates are doing well, you know, ask for help, continue to move on, but get over that feeling of wanting to impress people, of looking around and seeing how what everyone else is doing, and understand that you are also good enough. So last tip, number five, is basically understand all the doors that are still open. If you do have a setback, you know, when I had that MCAT score, which is fine again, but not probably good enough for me to go to an Ivy League school, at least that's what I thought. And so when you are in those situations, you're like, man, I blew it, all my options are done, I can't get into medical school, I'm not gonna get into residency. And you have those conversations with yourself. Instead of worrying about all the doors that, you know, are looking like they're closing, look at all the doors that are still open. You know, again, you are a successful individual because of all the hard work you have put in to get to this point. And because you've done so, there are still gonna be doors open for opportunity for you, and to understand that they're still there. So if you are a first year or second year med student, you take your step one exam, you don't do as well as you want, that's going to be considered a failure initially in your mind, but understand there are so many doors still open. You can still do whatever you want to, regardless of what somebody tells you. And so just focus on the doors of opportunity that are still open versus the doors that look like they're closing inside your head. But guys, all of those five tips were basically how I approach failure and self-doubt on a day-to-day basis. I deal with it all the time. It's hard not to. I'll be honest, on your medical journey, where there are so many amazing people that are brilliant, that are smart, that are successful around you, but remember that you are one of those individuals too. So if you deal with self-doubt, make sure you remember these five principles. If you have another principle that you kind of use to help yourself overcome self-doubt or failure, you know, I'd love to hear about it. And I know other readers and subscribers want to hear about it, so make sure you comment down below. But if you did enjoy this video, first of all, as always, make sure you give this video a like. Subscribe to the channel. As I mentioned, we are almost to 1,000 subscribers. That was my goal for 2018. So I would highly appreciate it if you helped me get there. But as always, if you guys have any questions, you can comment down below. You can send me a message. Check out the links in the description if you want some free resources. If you're struggling with something specific on your medical journey, whether that be studying or something else, there's probably something in those links for you. But I'm going to stop babbling. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you like and subscribe. And as always, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.